Alright, welcome back everybody to Dishonored Part 10. We are nearing the conclusion of the game. And we are now back in order to reach the
Please! No! Oh, it's you, Corvo.
Hope everybody's doing well today.
We all thought you'd been killed.
Trying to get my bearings.
Except for Samuel.
I know it's been a while since I played.
He seemed sure
Dishonored,
you'd survived.
So.
I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore.
Yeah, well.
But I'll bet he's still
Samuel.
Out there.
Yeah, I gotta get out of here. Get some food. Basically almost dead after the last episode, where I just basically rushed everything to death. Yeah.
You lost your senses?
Get it. See if there's anything here. No.
Havelock called us into the yard, but I wasn't feeling well. I just watched from the attic. The Admiral brought his cutlass.
Where are you going?
He stuck Wallace through the eye. Did you do that?
Yep.
They said it was time for Sokolov. By the outsider himself. What is this?
Yeah, shut up. Alright, so we got a tall boy over here. Gotta figure out how to get out of here without Uber detected.
You look at this mess?
Relax.
Emily was there when the killing started. Poor child. If you ask me, I hope she hit her eyes.
Through the mask.
Admiral said that Martin was right.
That's what a rational person would do. Not this guy. Yep. Stay in the house. I hear they had to hide the Caldwell girl from him the whole time they were working with him. I heard they locked him in a cage and only let him out at night.
Criminal mind, huh? So what's he doing now?
For a second, I thought that was a good idea. I'm trying to figure out how they
get crazy. Closer and closer, ever closer,
nope.
Until...
Cut it out. What's so impressive about Corvo, anyway? Who's he got up against? A couple of high overseers, a couple of noblemen? He could never stand up to men with our training.
Well, now I do hope he shows up. I want to see you run crying for the cover of the tall boys out back.
Like you were, the other night.
What was I supposed to do?
Alright, nice. In here.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Sad hearts, the City Watch must announce the death of the Lord Regent, Hiram Burrows. May his spirit fade from this world and suffer no more.
Take her place in a mere decade or so.
See, this is why I don't do stealth games. But I really like this game. Which is why I did it. But I do like to rush things sometimes because, you know, sometimes stealth games aren't exactly entertaining for the internet. So, I'm assuming all the guys just rush the stuff. Entire open space. That guy is somehow dead. I don't know how. Oh, I already have that. Read the letter from Emily. That's what her body is supposed to look like. Like, I mean, this is a tower I'm supposed to go to, right? Emily's tower. But she's dead!
I hereby appoint the Lord Trevor Pendleton to the office of Prime Minister.
Is dead. Well, not here. Can't see me. Bricks.
Huh?
So that means Piero and probably like Sokolov is probably like dead too. Dead.
I don't know if anyone will hear this.
Oops. You guys want to listen to this? I'll listen.
I don't know if anyone will hear this. The others took Emily away in a boat. I don't know where, and her hair hasn't been combed yet. I worry who will look after her. I didn't even get a chance to say goodbye.
Yeah, me neither. Yeah, forget Havelock, I don't care. Right here, baby.
Thought I'd find you here.
Never pays to bet against you, does it? I saw the signal. I knew you'd be back, Corvo. I knew it. We should start off soon. I've been feeling something in my bones, and if it's plague, well, I can't be counted on to drive this boat much longer. Good. Then it's one more trip across the river to where it meets the sea. That's where the Lord Regent was building his new lighthouse. Ought to be something to see.
Let's go! So that is it for Dishonored Part 10. I'm gonna prep for the conclusion. I'll see you guys in the next part. Thanks for watching.